If you see the acceleration and top speed reduced warning in a Tesla, this is a pretty common problem, and usually you will have two types of codes with this BMS U008 and BMS A170. So these are two types of codes that can pop up in different situations. You can check the codes using the screen in your car, so it's quite easy to find. These codes are battery management system, so BMS, battery management system codes. And the problem is that they are generic codes, so they can mean anything at all. It's impossible to find the reason just seeing this error message and this code. So very often it's not a problem, and you should just keep driving and then stop your car, lock it, let it sit for a while, unlock it and start driving it again. And in a lot of cases, this error message will disappear and your Tesla will just drive like it normally does. So it's some kind of a glitch that no one knows how it happens, but sometimes this message appears and the limp mode may turn on or may not turn on. So your performance and top speed acceleration may be changed or may not be changed. It doesn't change anything. So you may just leave your car for some time and then it will start and drive just normally. And this is the cheapest way to try and solve this problem. And if this doesn't help, you may also try checking if these codes are old, because after you install an update in your Tesla, it will also show you all the error messages that are stored in the brain. So if these error messages are old, there is also a free way to cure your car. You just need to reset, hard reset your software. And for this, you will just need to press both steering wheel buttons and hold them for 10 seconds. This is the easy way to reset the old codes that your car shows to you. Now, if you can't reset these codes and these error messages and they don't disappear, so they keep reappearing all the time, you probably will need some inspection. And the first thing to do is to try the remote inspection offered by Tesla. So you apply for remote inspection, they will see the codes and they will maybe try reset some electronic control module, or maybe they will tell you that it's impossible to diagnose your car remotely and they will ask you to come to the dealership. But one of the things to try is to ask for remote inspection and save your time. Now, a lot of Tesla owners will ask if you can drive when you see this warning. Well, one time in my life, I actually seen this message was connected with the problem, and this was a rare drive unit problem. And yes, it wasn't really recommended to drive one time in my life, and all other cases, it's hundreds of cases, this message was just a glitch. So it was just cured by reset. Sometimes the reset had to be made in a dealership because just a hard reset with the steering wheel buttons didn't work. But you may need to go to the dealership and you may try driving. So you may drive your car when you see these error messages, but you should also notice any changes in how your vehicle behaves. If the top speed is reduced, if the acceleration is bad, it's okay, because this is the limp mode that is programmatically turned on and your car will just limit the speed. It's not a problem. But if you see any noises, if the steering of your car changes, if there is some problem of how the car behaves on the road, you most likely don't need to drive this car. You need to call a tow truck, to call a dealership maybe, and find the way to get your car to the dealer and to have it inspected properly.